Hi friends, welcome back to this React.js advanced concept series. In the last video, I have explained about use reducer hook. In this video, I am going to talk about use imperative handle in depth. Let's start. What is use imperative handle? The use imperative handle hook is a powerful tool in React that allows us to expose functions or values from a child component to a parent component. This enables the parent component to directly control the behavior of the child component without using traditional prop-based communication. But before diving into use imperative handle, it's important to understand forward ref. This is necessary because use imperative handle relies on forwarded refs. Okay, and to understand forward ref, you should know about what is ref in React and how we can use that to access DOM elements. I have explained this in my use ref in-depth video. I suggest you to watch that first before this video. Okay, let me also give a small overview on ref and why we need forward ref using a simple example. Consider this application. Here we have a text box and a button. The requirement is to focus the text box on clicking this button. For that, we can use ref. Let me create a ref using useRef. And let me connect my input box using that ref. And so now inside this function, I can use this ref to access my text box element. I can call the focus function from this ref.current to focus the text box. Let me show you. Now we can see on clicking this button, the text box is getting focused. Okay. Here we have both the input box and the button are present in the same component. Assume we have a child component and we are having our input box in the child component and the button in the parent component. Now how can we achieve this requirement? We can use forward ref for this. Forward ref is a technique in React to forward refs to child components, making it possible to access a child component's DOM nodes or React elements from a parent component. Let me show you. First, instead of connecting my input element, let me connect the child component itself. And in the child component, let me use forward ref. Forward ref takes a function as an argument. This function receives two parameters, props and ref. The ref is passed directly to the input element like this. And please note that even though we are not using these props anywhere, we have to mention here because ref is going to be the second argument. If we miss to mention that, we will get error because now this will be considered as props and the function will expect the ref. Okay, let's test it. We can see now it is working. Okay, now let me explain the use of useImperativeHandle. For that, first let me show you an example. Consider this application. Here I have a parent component and a child component. In the parent component, I am having a count state and a function to increase that count. I am showing that count state here and then I am having the child component. In the child component, I am having a button. So now the requirement is to increase this count in the parent component when this button in the child component is clicked. We can achieve this easily because this is straightforward. In the parent component, we can pass this function as a prop to the child component. And in child component, we can get this prop and directly invoke it. And so we can see it is working. Okay, now let's reverse this requirement. Let me have the state and the increase function in the child component and the button in the parent component. Now, how can we do? Here we cannot pass the function through props because we can access only the child component from the parent component. We can access the parent component directly from the child component. So what we can do? We can introduce a state in the parent component and let's change that state when the button is clicked. And then let's pass this state as a prop to the child component. In the child component, let's get this prop and let's introduce an use effect. Like this. Now when the prop is changed, this use effect will be triggered and so this function will be invoked. And so we can see when we click, this count is getting increased. But here also, if I click again, it won't work because the state is already changed to false. So what we can do? we can add a set timeout after this and set the state back to false. Now this will work, but this is an ugly fix. Now let's see how we can achieve this using useImperativeHandle hook. Okay, first let me create a ref using useRef. And bind it to this child component. Now we will get an error because we cannot directly use a ref on the child component unless we use forward ref. So let me introduce forward ref in the child component. Also, let me introduce the useImperativeHandle hook here. This useImperativeHandle hook accepts three arguments. First one is the forwarded ref. So let me give this here. Second one is a function that returns an object with methods or values we want to expose. So here, let me expose my increase function. Third one is an array of dependencies that determine when the return instance is updated. Let's ignore it for now as it is optional. Okay, now this increase function is exposed to our parent component. And so our parent component can access this function through the ref. Like this. Okay, let's test it. Now it is working as expected. Hope you understood about how to use useImperativeHandle hook. Let's see one more example to understand how dependency array works in useImperativeHandle hook. In this application, I am showing a status as offline. I can use these two buttons to change the status. But the status will not be reflected until I click this refresh status button. Let's see the code. Here in the child component, I'm having the status as state and I'm changing that using these two buttons. So once the status is updated, this child component re-renders and so this computed status will be calculated. And I'm using a ref to show that computed status as inner text of this div. Also, I'm doing that inside this refresh method which is exposed to parent through useImperativeHandle hook. I am using computed status as a dependency. That is why when the computed status is changed, the useImperativeHandle hook runs and it updates the refresh method. If I remove this dependency, we can see even after the state has been changed in the child component, the parent component is not aware of that and so this is not working. Okay, before we close, let's see some best practices, when to use and when not to use useImperativeHandle hook and some performance considerations. We need to use useImperativeHandle hook only when we need to expose specific methods to parent component like focusing on an input or starting and stopping a timer. Expose only what's necessary to avoid making our child component hard to manage. React works best when changes are managed through state and props. So if we can update our UI using state, we need to prefer that instead of directly calling methods with useImperativeHandle. Always mention only the needed dependencies to avoid exposing outdated or unnecessary methods. In exposed methods, we should not use heavy logic. This may slow down our app. Make sure you clean up any resources like timers or event listeners when they are no longer needed. That's all for today. If you enjoyed this, don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment below with any questions or future topics you'd like to see. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video. Bye.